rain in the area. And the Christine Bonatti Bullwinkle Arena, the only thing that you need to be worrying about is the raining shots from the Eureka College women's basketball team as they prepare to take on the Kalamazoo Hornets. Spencer Davis, Joshua Howard with me as always. Joshua, it's a tough timeout against the Illinois Wesleyan right before break, but we're back now, back with some good food in our systems. We're going to see if it pays off. Take us through that last game.
So that last game, you know, we really saw a good start from the Lady Devils. The defense was there. It was doing its job, limiting that team to 8 points. And then it kind of just got out of hand from that point. The defense was not able to sustain itself. The offense, they were never really truly able to find their offense. The flow that it seemed like they kind of were getting in the first quarter, it just seemed like it was completely cut off. The doubles of Wesleyan just seemed to really kind of wear on the ball handlers of Eureka, and over time the turnovers just piled up and the game kind of got out of hand, and before you know it, it was a little too late to salvage. But still, we saw a lot of good things, a lot of things that the women can improve upon, especially against this Kalamazoo team.
Yeah, Kalamazoo comes into this one looking for their first win of the season. They're coming off of a loss at Manchester, so a good opportunity for the Red Devils also to get back on the winning track.
Yeah, both teams, in a way, kind of a little bit desperate, you know, them for their first win. And then the Lady Devils obviously want their first home win of the season. Hopefully third time's a charm is pretty sure what they're thinking. And they're looking to see if they can take this team out because, as you said, this team has yet to win a game. And it should be one that they're very capable of.
Josh, what are your three keys to the game?
So first, out-rebounding, you know, limiting a team to one shot at worst, maybe two occasionally on a possession, not letting them get a bunch of opportunities to score. Secondarily, you know, keep up that suffocating defense. This team is not very efficient over at Kalamazoo, and if that defense remains, then they should have a pretty bad shooting night, and the Red Devils should be able to run away with this. And then three, just being consistent, playing a full 40 minutes, you know, seeing that effort in both halves, in all four quarters, and just making sure that, you know, they play as a team and they play together for that full 40 so they can secure this win.
And that's all we have for you on the pregame show. We've got the national anthem coming up on the other side. We've got starting lineups in the first half of action. You're watching Eureka College Basketball on ECTV.
Football has taught me a lot throughout my life. It's definitely had a huge imprint on who I am as a person. Competing at a Division III level created that opportunity for me to go to college. Not only was I the first one in my family to graduate college, but I was really the first one to even go. Being the first one, I'm breaking that cycle, and now that I've graduated, I'm not sure what's the next step, but I know I have a lot of doors open. And a lot of those are open because I played football and ran track here at Otterbein.
150 over 90.
180 over 111.
160 over 110. I had a stroke.
This is what high blood pressure looks like. You might not feel its symptoms, but the results from a stroke are far from invisible or silent. If you've come off your treatment plan, get back on it, or talk with your doctor to create an exercise, diet, and medication plan that works for you. Go to loweryourhbp.org.
If I would have followed a treatment plan, I would not be in this situation.
When I was in foster care, I never knew when I would have to move, so I always had my suitcase ready to go. Then one day, I was adopted. My new parents opened their hearts and home to me. My parents cook my favorite breakfast for me every morning. My parents take me on trips I never thought I would go on. They gave me a home and an even better reason to use that suitcase. My parents aren't perfect, but they're perfect for me.
And we'll send it down to Blake Baxter, who's got the starting lineups.
Now let's meet today's starting lineups, first for the visiting Kalamazoo Hornets. A 5'8" junior from Portage, Michigan, number 4, Maddie Kaufman. A 5'9" senior from Durham, North Carolina, number 10, Kyla Davis. A 5'8" sophomore from Kalamazoo, Michigan, number 22, Jalen Horn. A 6-foot junior from Otsego, Michigan, number 33, Kaylin Arlington. And a 5'8 junior from East Lansing, Michigan, number 44, Sarah English. The Hornets were coached by head coach Katie Miller and assisted by Jessica Rausch, Emily Lindsay, and Kelsey Howell. Now let's meet tonight's starting lineups for your Eureka Red Devils. A 5'3 senior from Clinton, Illinois, number 1, Savannah Moore. A 5'5 senior from Hanover, Michigan, number 10, Shekiah Rogers. A 5'8 senior from Canton, Illinois, number 14, Sydney Hannum. A 5'9 senior from Wyoming, Illinois, number 20, Abby Stotler. And a 5'11 sophomore from Sandwich, Illinois, number 33, Josie Ness. The Red Devils are coached by head coach Jalen Stewart and assisted by Reese Capino and Richard Bolden.
So we've got our starting lineups. Josh, who do you have your eyes on in this one?
So in this one, I'm going to be really looking at Ness. We saw last game her playmaking on full display, especially early on, but really throughout the game in that high post area. As long as the Red Devil women are cutting, it seems like they can get layups all day or at least create some sort of look by the attention she attracts on defense. So that's going to be a good way to start for them.
So we're going to have Ness and Arlington to tip this one off. Happy Sunday. Not every week we get to call a game on a Sunday.
Oh, yeah, and it's good to see Savannah Moore back on the floor.
It'll be Ness losing the tip here, and it's going to be the Hornets starting on offense. Sarah English guarded by Shekiah Rogers. This is Jalen Horn going to work on Hannum. Good hands from Hannum. Knocks it out of bounds. Already the defensive intensity is good.
Yeah, good hands right there to avoid the foul and get a clean strip.
Horn to inbound. No one open. Ness with good hands, kept in bounds, and then punted. It's going to be a foul on Kaufman.
So, you know, the my keys to the game so far are looking kind of good. You know, the defensive intensity is there. They obviously want to suffocate this Kalamazoo team, and it's looking good so far.
Forcing a turnover 15 seconds in is usually a good thing. It'll be Sydney Hannum and Shekiah Rogers now for the Red Devils. Ness with a screen and then a foul once again on the perimeter. Two quick fouls, already three fouls away from the bonus.
Yeah, it's always good to get into the bonus early in a quarter or a half. And, you know, obviously you get free throws every foul after that.
Be Stotler now handing off Rogers. A little miscommunication there between the two. Ness catches the deflected pass, goes down. 10 on the shot clock. This is Moore now making her return, as Josh said. Hannum, 4 on the shot clock, has to put one up. That one scraped for him. Moore could not bring it in. It was knocked out of bounds by a Hornet.
Red Devils getting a third chance here on offense. Looking a bit out of sorts, but that may be, you know, possibly due to the return of Moore. They're all getting acclimated again.
Ness can't finish there. Ball gets knocked out of bounds. It's going to say off of Davis. So another opportunity on offense.
Hey, we'll take as many chances as we can get.
Handoff. Rogers now, nice move all the way to the rim and puts it in for our first basket of the night.
And we're seeing the press here early. We didn't really see it as much against Wesleyan in that prior game.
And maybe that's just because Moore's back.
Yeah, maybe that's because Moore's back. We did talk about the pressure she adds at the top of the press, and she's usually the one guarding the guards that are getting inbounded to.
Arlington's jumper is no good. It's going to be Eureka back on the break. All the way to the corner. Hannum now from three. No good. And then knocked out of the hands of Horn.
Hannum can definitely shoot. Do not expect those looks to miss for long.
8:33 remaining in this first quarter. Just underway in Eureka. Arlington now the leading scorer for the Hornets. Almost knocked away on the perimeter.
Yeah, Stotler nearly getting a steal right there.
Wraparound pass, unable to find anyone.
The defense looking good so far. You know, they're over. Over under 3 minutes without them scoring. We're almost at two.
Well, I'll take the over on that.
I'm going to take the over.
Red Devils defense looks legit. New entry onto the floor, Jackie Brines.
I'm really hoping we didn't just jinx them and they don't just come down and like hit a three.
be Ness now at the elbow. Is that backdoor cut able to find Hannum? Rework the offense with 13 on the shot clock. Be Ness trying to find that backdoor cut once again. Here's Hannum, 5 on the shot clock. Nice spin. Back out Stotler from 3. Yes!
A team of stretch bigs as well. That's really going to help the offense if they can widen the paint out a little bit because this defense has to respect shooters.
Stotler picks off that pass but stepped out of bounds. Here early. Red Devil lead.
To no surprise, the Red Devil's a little fiery after the way they lost that game. Probably upset about it. Want to make sure they come out and get this one. And they're showing they're very much capable.
This is English now, guarded by Rogers. That bounce pass able to be brought in by Brines. Tries to drive, offensive foul, charge drawn by Moore.
Great defense by Moore. And I believe the third or fourth turnover they've already forced here early on.
Red Devils back on offense now. Trying to extend their lead already, a two-possession game. Here's Moore, Ness. Hannum. Of course, the kick back out. Deep two there from Moore. Good box outs underneath by Arlington.
Same thing for Moore. She can also shoot, so do not expect these misses to go for long.
Brines on the sideline. Ooh, they get a foul on Moore. Well, Josh, only need 4 more seconds to elapse here, and we're in good shape.
We get some crazy half-court shot for no reason, just so we lose. Looks like we got it, though.
Hey. To be Horn trying to drive baseline. Forced to kick back out. Arlington now. And Ness with good hands to knock it away.
And the defense keeping up. Obviously, we want them to hold them scoreless for as long as they possibly can. It's looking good so far.
Moore able to tiptoe along that sideline. Stotler now from the elbow. No good. And then off the knee of Arlington.
So far, the Lady Devils playing very, very good basketball, getting a lot of quality looks here early on.
Macy Ivins onto the floor now for the Hornets. Already 2 early substitutions for the Hornets. And resetting the shot clock to 30. Originally, I thought they had an offensive foul on Moore on that.
I just didn't know what it was going to be.
Moore tries to go cross corner. Ivins now.
That's providing pressure up top at the top of the key.
The Horn now, guarded by Hannum. Looking to get a screen from Arlington. Horn looking to drive off the glass.
I believe that was tipped. Not sure, but I believe that was tipped by Ness.
Horn once again down the post, gets trapped, kicks back out. Ivins, 5 on the shot clock, 3-pointer up. English knocks one in.
1st points of the game, probably a sigh of relief for Kalamazoo over there.
Finally got the lid off the basket.
Yeah.
Seems like the first shot they've really gotten off in a while.
But yeah, honestly, a lot of times they get turned over before they really get a look.
Hannum run off the 3-point line through contact. We'll go to the free throw line after the blocking foul.
And also a key really we didn't see as much in the Wesleyan game. We talked about the free throws they got the game prior against Beloy. You know, getting back to that free throw line, Hannum really leading the charge in that game, going 10 for 10. And now it's good to see her back at the stripe.
Jernigan onto the floor for Moore. 5:42 remaining in this first quarter. Hannum's first is good. Comes into this one shooting 83% from the line.
Yeah, the leading scorer for this Lady Devils team at 17 a game.
Now 7-3 after the 2 made free throws. Kaufman now able to get it up the sideline to Ivins. 3-pointer up from English once again. That one's short. Rebounded by Ness.
A little bit of point forward action there briefly, but she gave it up.
Stotler now, top of the key. Here's Ness. Stotler with a nice little head fake. Gets the elbow, swings. Rogers 10 on the shot clock. Ness now in the post. Back out. Stotler from three. That one's short.
You can tell Stotler has a very well-fleshed-out game. She's comfortable in the post or stretching out from two or all the way to the three-point line.
English tries to go back door, kept in bounds by Kaufman. Davis now back out. Ivins resetting. 12 on the shot clock. Screen from three-pointer up and knocked in.
Another tray for Kalamazoo. So far, all their points coming from behind the three-point line.
7-6 our score. Hand them now to Ness.
Last thing you want to do is allow a team like this to get confidence.
Good find from Hannum. Stotler fouled.
I'm waiting for the chance to just be able to scream and one. It's going to be hype.
.421 remaining in this first quarter of action. That one's in to start. Marissa Murphy preparing to come in for Stotler. She will do so after the successful trip to the line. Actually, she's going to come on for Ness. Like you said, Josh, Hornets are just shooting from three.
Yeah, they're just shooting from three, and maybe that's the type of team that they are. You did talk about earlier how they're a team that has a higher three-point field goal percentage than overall field goal percentage, so maybe that's kind of where they see themselves specializing.
Go to the high post. Davis now to the corner. Kaufman forced to pick up her dribble in a tough spot. Davis once again. Back out, Ivins. 10 on the shot clock. Going to cross up on Hannum. Hannum caught a knee on that Ivins all the way to the basket and finishes.
Able to slip through the cracks right there off a good screen by her teammate. Able to get the score inside the paint.
Murphy cutting contact. More free throws for the Red Devils.
Once again, I love the aggression going towards the rim. I believe in the bonus now for the rest of the quarter.
Yeah, yep. Just under 4 minutes to go still. So plenty of time to get some free points.
At this point, they might as well just drive every play. Not really, but you know, you want to get those free throws if you can.
Murphy only attempted two free throws so far this season. Still looking for her first make. And able to get into the score sheet. And that one in as well. Reese Putrick preparing to come in. She will do so. To come in for Stotler.
It kind of fills the role very perfectly. She has stretched for herself, can shoot the two and the three very well as has a post game.
It's good to see the Red Devils running this press. I think it just adds another layer to their team.
I definitely think it does, and obviously we see the way the defense is suffocating. A steal right there by Rogers.
And then fouled at half court. Two more free throws. .337 left. Only 10 seconds elapsed between that play and more free throws.
Yeah. Seems like they kind of heard what we were saying. Or maybe coach just said it to him. Get to the rim.
Or in this case, just get to the half court line because I guess they'll foul you there.
Yeah. I mean, a lot of times when players turn the ball over, they immediately want to foul and get it back. So kind of works out in their favor right here.
Hey, Rogers first, no good. I know I was like that. If I turned the ball over, I got angry and would often commit dumb fouls.
Yeah, it's kind of like just natural for most players. It happens.
And that one in as well. I think she would have gotten a mulligan, though, regardless. English now in that pass. Almost out of bounds. Horn keeps it in bounds. Kaufman now. Jernigan there. Now to English once again. Picked off by Rogers.
Rogers has magnets in her hands. If anyone is not aware, it seems like every time I look up, she's getting a steal.
Rogers can't quite finish, tries to keep it alive. And Jernigan had her hands on the ball when she stepped out of bounds. 12-8 the score, 3:16 left in the first quarter. Eureka looking to claim their first home win of the season. Obviously still very early, but things are looking up. English on the break now. Stop her drive. Going to go to Kaufman now. Back to Arlington. Kaufman now trying to work on Murphy. Gets a screen deep, two up, left it really short.
That defensive pressure of the Red Devils not stopping in the half court. Able to force an air ball right there.
Jackie Bryan's back onto the court for the Hornets.
I do have to say, I'm loving the pressure of the press. We've talked about it a few times, but even when they don't force turnovers, it seems like they're just inches away from some of these steals.
And it makes the pass really difficult. Hanum now from three. That's short.
Yeah, you can see they're really forcing Kalamazoo to speed up and making the women on their team uncomfortable. Right there.
And another turnover. That's nine now on the Hornets in this first quarter.
So what you're saying is we're on pace to force 40 turnovers.
Yes.
That
or
had
more.
To be a record or something. Yeah, or more.
I think that's a little above 40 at this point.
Yeah, actually it would be.
Murphy now finds Hanum. Nice pass. Good finish.
Red Devils stretching their lead back out again after it was cut to one briefly by Kalamazoo.
And Jernigan draws an offensive foul. It's rare to draw the offensive foul without going down.
Yeah, I was surprised by that. I was expecting to just hear, you know, the basic blocking foul at half, but we'll definitely take it.
That she had legal guarding position.
Yeah, she did. Stood there with her hands up, didn't really do anything. Didn't really have to oversell it either, just able to get the call.
Eureka looking to get a three-possession lead now. Kutrick now, Jernigan. Hanum once again underneath, and this time fouled. That's three fouls on Brines.
Early, very, very early. It's the first. Imagine fouling out in the first half, potentially.
That's the risk you run with. You know, you want to contest shots, obviously, but at the same time, you have to be mindful of already having two.
Yeah, and it doesn't look like their coach is setting to sub anyone in, so I guess she's trusting her player.
And that one knocked in as well. Savannah Moore coming back into the game. It's going to be for Rogers. 16-8 now the score.
Good to see the defensive intensity ramping back up.
It's going to be a pass right to Jernigan, who knocks it to Hanum. Going to go to Putrick. Back to Jernigan. Jernigan power dribble off the glass and in. Now a 30-second timeout taken by the Hornets. 18-8 the score. Under 2 to go in this first quarter. Josh, what's standing out to you? What's the difference?
Well, really, so far, the Red Devils responding well. After having their lead cut to 1-7-6, they've now went on an 11-2 run since, distancing themselves, putting themselves up double digits with a chance to keep it at that, if not extend their lead in this last minute 49. But mainly the defensive intensity is responsible for that. That press that we've talked about really forcing a lot of turnovers or passes because the Kalamazoo women are very uncomfortable with the pressure that they're dealing with.
Balanced scoring attack so far tonight from Eureka. Abby Stotler with 5, and then Marissa Murphy and Sydney Hanna both with 4.
Very, very good to see this team playing as a team, you know, getting it done collectively, a little bit of really effort from everyone. You see it on the defense, see it on the offense. It's great to see.
And we talked about it really early into this first quarter about how the bonus could come into play early. Red Devils have shot 10 free throws already tonight.
I want to see if we can beat that 44 pace. I don't know about it, but, you know, it's never that bad to get that many free throws.
Kaufman, Arlington swung back. English run off the three-point line. Elbow jumper off the glass. Rebounded by Kaufman. Turns and flings, gets her own miss, and then fouled by Putrick.
Yeah, surprisingly uncontested on that first rebound and able to fight through three Eureka women to get the second one. Props to her, and she gets a shot to get those 2 points at the line.
And that's onto the court for Putrick. First free throws on the way for the Hornets. Our score, 1:33 remaining in this first quarter. Kaufman will get into the scorer's column with that one. Already 4 rebounds for her as well.
Nice little game she's got going so far.
That one no good. Rebounded by the Red Devils. And then Moore is fouled, so more free throws for the Red Devils.
Chance to hang 20 here in this first quarter against Kalamazoo.
New entries onto the floor.
I don't know why. Sometimes it seems like the walk from one end of the court to the other for free throws is like the longest walk in the world. Team's probably, you know, taking their time, though, catching their breath as they get back down.
That one is good. Moore now 7 of 8 from the free throw line this season.
Is that about 88% on the season?
Yeah, yep.
Quick math.
Hey, and we're not even math majors. How about that?
Yeah.
Who said comm majors don't know how to count? With 20-9, the score, minute and a half left in this first quarter. Hanum heads to the bench. Stotler's back in. Kaufman now up the sideline. Ivins picked off. We're going to call it by Jernigan, but Stotler recovers it.
You see that press trying to force them to really, they're trying to make quicker decisions, but still working out in the favor of the Lady Devils on that possession.
Here's Ness now all the way to the rim. Can't finish. Arlington rebounds. English now pushing it up. Defending off Murphy. It's Kaufman now. Arlington. English has it once again. Arlington trying to size up Ness. Spins to her left. Can't finish. Good box out by Ness.
Yeah, great defense down there by Ness. Dealing with a big body and still able to get the stop.
Murphy with a nice spin move and great finish.
That was very nice. Extremely beautiful move there by Murphy. I'm not even sure if I can pull that off at this point.
Jernigan now with the steal, and then Ness is fouled.
Still waiting on that N1 call. It's going to be so amazing.
The horn's back onto the floor for Kaufman.
I kind of feel like I have to restate. I'm impressed and, you know, enjoying how well the Red Devils responded after their lead was cut to one. They've completely pulled away here, a chance to go up 15.
And it's really because of that press, I would say.
I definitely jinxed that with that. Yeah. But
it happens.
But the press, you know, the press doing its job, doing what, you know, coach intended for it to, getting back-to-back offensive possessions.
That one no good either. Ness fights for her offensive rebound, though.
Yeah, getting it through two Kalamazoo women.
20 seconds. Eureka going to hold for the last shot of the quarter. Stotler, 15 seconds left now. Ness at that elbow. Under 10. Able to find Stotler. Stotler spins. Puts up a shot. No good. Rebounded by English. They're going to stop her at half court. And that shot is off in time, but left short. So at the end of the first quarter, 22-9 in favor of the Red Devils.
Yes.
Josh. So far, so good.
Yeah, the second consecutive first quarter where the Red Devils have held their opponent in single digits. It's very good to see their defense coming out the gate, you know, really ready to apply that pressure and cause chaos for the other team.
We'll be back in 30 seconds with the second quarter of action. You're watching Eureka College Basketball on ACTV.
Football has taught me a lot throughout my life. It's definitely had a huge imprint on who I am as a person. Competing at a Division III level created that opportunity for me to go to college. Not only was I the first one in my family to graduate college, but I was really the first one to even go. Being the first one, I'm breaking that cycle, and now that I've graduated, I'm not sure what's the next step, but I know I have a lot of doors open. And a lot of those are open because I played football and ran track here at Otterbein.
Both teams preparing to take the floor for the second quarter of action. Spencer Davis and Joshua Howard with you once again. Joshua, another fantastic quarter in the books.
Yeah, very great first quarter showing by the Red Devils. We saw a little bit of everything. We saw that offense starting to get to flowing. We saw the defense. We saw them responding well to some early adversity. It's good to see them coming out running on all cylinders.
And the turnover battle is what really jumps out. Only two for the Red Devils, and they have forced 13.
Yeah, it's always good to be on the right end of, you know, a big, big turnover gap, and that shows your defense is doing its job and your ball handlers and the rest of the team also doing their job, not really being loose with the ball.
Red Devils also leading the, or losing actually, the rebounding battle.
Well, you know, it's not that big of a key to the game. If they're playing the way they're playing, it doesn't, you know, Obviously, we don't want to lose anything, but we want to win the game ultimately.
Getting to the line has been the difference so far. 14 attempts so far from the free throw line. More left open from three, and that one's knocked in.
Looks like their jump shot's starting to kind of warm up. We talked about the last few games. A lot of their very good shooters having good looks and at times struggling. We definitely didn't expect that to stay the same, and seems like it's kind of changing as they almost get a turnover right there.
Little stoppage of play here to reset the clock or shot clock, one of the two. It's going to be Horn to try to inbound. Here's English. Trying to break this press. Only 2 seconds to get across. They're able to do so. Ivins now. And we talked about in that previous game, the press is kind of meant for you to speed things up, but also to slow you down.
Yeah, in a weird way, it's supposed to speed you up in your decision making, but because it's, you know, supposed to do that, it's also supposed to make you kind of like slow down because you don't want to rush and then make a mistake and turn the ball over. So it's weird. It speeds you up, but also slows you down.
After that foul by Moore. The 20 seconds on the shot clock. That's Moore's second. Something to monitor as we get further into this first half. English tries a bounce pass, not quite there.
Yeah, and Jernigan able to keep it in bounds. A bit of point forward action again here by Stotler.
Stotler dishes. Jernigan now and Ness. Able to find Jernigan cutting. Can't quite finish. Cook with the rebound. And Ness able to poke one away. Trying to finish on the left side. Pauses for a moment. Absorbs a little bit of contact. English is still down. Obviously in some discomfort.
I'm wondering if maybe there was a knock of knees there or if she just went down in an awkward way. Definitely seems to be something with the leg.
Yeah, not putting any sort of pressure on it. Good to see it. She's getting over to the sideline. It might just be, I didn't see anything that was, I thought there was contact. So obviously you never want to actually get dinged, but
yeah.
When it comes to the knee, it's better to get hit with a knee than it is to just go down because of nothing.
Yeah.
Be Kaufman now as play is restarted. Horn all the way up the sideline with Ivins. Red Devils almost trap her on that Kaufman corner, as you call it.
You can see Kalamazoo's trying to adjust to the press, and it's working at times, but still causing trouble is another player hobbled right there, Kaufman. She seems fine. It was just a brief little tweak.
Five on the shot clock now. Horn's going to have to put something up. Trying to get separation. Kicks back out. Davis, and the shot clock is going to expire.
Great defense there by Moore. Despite guarding the bigger player, able to get the stop and force a shot clock violation. And the effort really of the entire team forcing that violation.
27-9 our score, Eureka leading. Moore now on the right side, guarded by Kaufman. Rogers now looking to get a screen from Ness, doesn't use it, goes all the way to the basket, contact. No call, ball still loose, Ivins has it. And Ness gets caught with her hand in the cookie jar.
So far, the defense kind of working wonders the same way it started off the first quarter. This team, this Kalamazoo team, scoreless here so far, 2 minutes in. I'm not going to do an over-under again, though, because I definitely am. I'm not feeling it, you know. I feel like the moment I say that, they're just going to go down and score some crazy half-court shot.
Ms. Magnets with a layup and a steal.
If we had a basketball reference, that would have to be her nickname.
Oh, absolutely. Another tip pass by Shakaya Rogers. And the jump ball. Possession arrow belongs to the Hornets.
Good to see that aggression still, though. Obviously, the next time they get a jump ball, it's going to go the way of the Red Devils. So it's going to pay off eventually.
Turnover battle now sitting at 2-17. So that press has done wonders for the Red Devils so far.
I was half joking, thinking there's no way we could force 40 turnovers, but they're well above that pace right now.
Arlington goes down, loose ball. Stotler hops over, able to find Hannum. And Hannum uncontested and in.
So far, the Lady Devils doing their job, extending their lead to 22.
31-9 our score, 2.5 minutes into the second quarter. Teams are taking a timeout. We're going to do the same. You're watching Eureka College Basketball on ECTV.
150 over 90.
180 over 111.
160 over 110. I had a stroke.
This is what high blood pressure looks like. You might not feel its symptoms, but the results from a stroke are far from invisible or silent. If you've come off your treatment plan, get back on it, or talk with your doctor to create an exercise, diet, and medication plan that works for you. Go to loweryourhbp.org.
If I would have followed a treatment plan, I would not be in this situation.
Coming back out of the break, Eureka Red Devils tearing things up, to say the least.
Yeah, definitely causing a lot of chaos, like we said a few minutes ago. You know, still holding this Kalamazoo Hornets team scoreless in this quarter, and they've extended their lead passing the 20-point mark a few minutes ago.
Teams resuming play. Foul sitting at 2 on Eureka this half, and none so far on the Hornets. So a better start for the Kalamazoo Hornets.
Yeah, much better start here. The ramped up aggression always risks more fouls when you're trying to obviously make a team uncomfortable on defense. But, you know, it's a given so far, and it's worked out well.
And a push call there.
Now they're kind of getting close to the bonus here early. Whether intentional or unintentional, could benefit them in the quarter if the Red Devils are unable to stop fouling.
Trap put on there. 5 seconds to get it across half court. Ivan's not yet over. Little banana route to get across. Behorn now. Davis. Into the post. Cook, Ness trying to fight that one off. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Davis once again. Kaufman able to bring it in. Flips it to the corner with Horn. Horn trying to put something up. Off the glass. No rim. Rebounded by Ness.
And another great defensive possession. We can't help but continue to sing their praises, but they continue to get stops. No matter how big their lead is, they aren't getting complacent. They're continuing to play hard.
Rodgers now getting a screen from Ness. All the way to the basket. Scoop and fouled. Two more free throws on the way for the Red Devils. Rodgers, 1 of 2 from the free throw line tonight. And 2 for 3 now after that first attempt. It'll be Murphy preparing to come in at the next dead ball. And there's the dead ball. 2 for 2 from the free throw line there.
Yeah, another good outing at the free throw line as we see the press that at this point has to be giving Kalamazoo nightmares setting up again.
I'm going to have nightmares about it, and honestly, I don't have to do anything about it.
It's working for us, and yeah. I'm still scared.
And Ms. Magnet's knocking that one out of bounds. Rodgers with 7 points and numerous deflected passes.
And probably at least 2 or 3 steals so far also.
Davis trying to get open, able to find Kaufman. Cook now fouled, going to the free throw line. Hornets look to crack double digits on this trip.
And still looking for the first points of the quarter, I just now noticed.
Stifling defense, to say the least. Cook's first is good. That one no good. 33-10 our score. Offensive rebound. Jump ball is the call. It's still going to be Eureka basketball.
Yeah, it's going to be Eureka basketball. Hopefully we don't see any more back-to-back, you know, two possession arrows this way or that way. And we're going to ignore the fact that it benefited us once, but that also worked against us another time.
Yeah, so it evened out.
It did.
Stotler now. Ness. Backdoor cut from Hannum, ball poked out of bounds.
You know she definitely has that high post playmaking ability, nearly getting another assist right there.
You can tell that Kalamazoo's done their homework, though. They've really done a good job of cutting off that backdoor pass.
Yeah, they probably saw it a lot in the Wesleyan game. It was probably the most consistent form of offense for the Red Devils in their last time out.
Davis and Ness fighting for it, and a foul called. Davis's third foul of the game, so she's coming off. Arlington back on. 6:05 to go in the first half. 23-point lead. Ness now up and no good. Stotler fighting for it. Kaufman brings it in.
Impressive save right there against the baseline.
Horn now pushing it up. English back on the floor. Good to see her back out there. Dribbled off of the foot of Cook, it looked like. Hannum still trying to bring it in. Ness eventually regains it.
Yeah, great defense by Ness and Hannum there, able to get the steal and get it back on their side.
Ness cutting now, lays it up. No good. English now might get trapped. Rogers picks off that pass. Uncontested layup is good.
Lead up to 25 now, and another frustration timeout there by Kalamazoo.
Yeah, Shakaya Rogers now leading the way for either team with 9 points, followed by really a very balanced attack from the Red Devils. Murphy and Hannum both with 6, and then Moore and Stotler with 5, and then 2 from Jernigan and Ness, respectively, as well.
The true definition of a team effort. You have multiple players hitting multiple shots, and then multiple players tied in scoring, so that shows you everyone's getting a look and everyone's getting a chance.
Helps when Eureka shooting 13 of 16 from the free throw line. Kalamazoo is 2 of 4.
It's always really good when you're not only getting to the line, but shooting above 80%. And obviously, they're converting at a great rate, and their defense stifling the Kalamazoo, who's shooting just over 21%.
They've only attempted 14 shots for the entire game. Eureka's attempted 24.
Yeah, and I think we talked about in the first quarter how a lot of times they weren't even getting down the floor to get attempts off, so that's probably a lot where that comes from, that press.
20 turnovers so far from Kalamazoo. So hopefully there's more.
Hopefully there is more.
Horn now working it around Ivins to the corner with Arlington. Arlington's three is blocked. Ball still loose. Kaufman has it. In a weird spot. Jump ball called.
This time it's going to stay with the Hornets.
7 seconds on the shot clock.
See English arguing her case with the ref. You know, they're fouling me, you know? Whether she's telling the truth or not, obviously trying to get the ref's attention on it.
Ness knocks that one out of bounds. Forced to go right back to the same spot. Able to inbound Horn. English, not a lot of time. Going to have to put a shot up. Ivins trapped in the corner. No shot is put up. Another turnover.
I believe that's the third shot clock violation of the quarter, too. So not only are they preventing them from scoring, but a lot of times they're not even able to put anything up. That's, I don't know, there's got to be a word better than stifling. That's just terrifying defense.
The Rogers now into Stotler. Stotler now through some contact. No call, and it's going to be off of Arlington. Good hustle from Ness.
Yeah, great hustle from Ness. Able to poke that off the opposing team and get the possession back.
4:35 remaining in the second quarter. Murphy inbounding to Rogers. Hannum thought about a three, decides not to. Back to Rogers. 10 on the shot clock. Rogers getting a screen from Ness to the corner with Murphy. Head fake. Back to Rogers. Rogers from three-point land. That one spins out. Hornets looking to push in transition. Ivins to English. English had that early three, and I don't know if she's taken another one since.
Yeah, kind of the defensive pressure really making her a little more hesitant from behind the line.
Going to have to break out the thesaurus in between halves. Come up with new words for our defense.
I definitely have to, because I don't know. It's just, it doesn't seem like anything we can think of is enough to describe this. 1 point so far in the second quarter. And that's ridiculous.
Foul committed by Hannum. Getting a little chippy down there.
I'd probably be chippy too if, you know, we only had 1 point over 6+ minutes. I might just foul like every single time at that point. Get me out the game. No, it's just fine. But, you know, definitely frustrating this Kalamazoo Hornets team, this defense. And honestly, like every single time they go to set up the press, it's just, you can probably see how tense this Hornets team is, knowing they have to find a way to get the ball up.
Arlington trying to argue her case for something. I don't. Also, isn't that, shouldn't that be free throws?
Oh, delay of game?
No, I think it's bonus, right?
Oh, you're saying for?
Yeah, because we
got
a foul, didn't we?
I believe so.
Huh. And a kick ball. I'm not gonna complain.
Yeah, we're not the, you know, we're not the referees. I don't know.
And another kick ball by Ness. Maybe she was watching a lot of World Cup action over break. Wouldn't blame her.
Definitely wouldn't blame her.
Avery Seidel onto the court for Hannum. Able to throw it over Ness, not by much. Kaufman now back over to English, keeps it in bounds. Right into that corner, here's Kaufman. Lob pass picked off, Murphy.
It's almost like Murphy saw the future on that one, able to just hop in and get her team out on the break.
Back to Seidel from three, not quite.
Seidel, definitely another one of those shoes you can expect to knock down those looks that they continue to come.
Ness picks off that pass. Putrick onto the floor once again. Seidel. Stotler now able to reel that one in, put it in off the glass.
There's Stotler's amazing post game and a dish by Seidel, giving her an assist early into her time on the court.
English now trying to dribble through the press. Able to pass to Ivins. And the pivot brought her on the wrong side of half court.
Yeah, so it looked like she had 2 feet on, I mean, a foot on both sides. And I was like, you know, are we going to call this?
37-10 our score. A few ticks under three to go in this first half of action. Eureka still looking for their first home win of the season. Murphy now with a cross floater. Not quite. Ness offensive rebound. And the basket's good.
We got the and one. It's lovely.
Ness finally gets a three-point play to go down for the Red Devils. Been waiting for it all game.
All game.
Free throw no good. Rebounded by Arlington.
It still counts in my book. You know, we still got the and one.
Yeah, we got the and one. We just wanted that. We'll take a three-point play on the next time.
Yeah, we'll get it next time.
Back on offense are the Red Devils. Murphy with a little duck of the shoulder getting around her defender. Stotler, no one on Putrick. Putrick left open from three. Not quite. Rebounded by Ness and fouled. Sometimes if you just don't get a lot of shots up consistently, it kind of resets your momentum, I would say, as a shooter.
Yeah, definitely does. Oh, well, it was a great look right there, though. The defense seemed to completely forget about Putrick, who's one of the best shooters on the floor. I guess they got a little bit lucky that she missed right there, but she's going to hit those very, very soon if she continues to get those looks.
Kism back on the floor. First time in a couple of games, at least. She wasn't on the floor for the Wesleyan game. Good to see her come back from injury.
It's good to see a lot of the Lady Devils getting healthy finally. This team getting to really build chemistry as a group now.
Putrick deep three, no good. Rebounded by Ivins. A lot of new faces on the floor. Ivins now back in the corner. One-handed pass, the catch there. Cook now rolling, puts it in over Ness.
I feel like, at least off memory, that's probably the first shot I've actually seen converted over Ness directly.
Putrick once again from three, this time no good. And the ball rolls out of bounds. Horn back onto the floor for Arlington. Number 23, Ella Boye on the floor as well for the Hornets. Minute 12 remaining. First half action. Ivins from three. That one's knocked in. 39-15 the score now. Still a Red Devil lead. Rogers pushing Kutrick once again from that corner. That one left short. Ness rebound. Steps through. Puts it up. No good. Rebounded by Cook.
I wouldn't be surprised at this point if Ness is closing in on a double-double. It seems like every time we look up, she's getting a rebound.
Three-pointer up, no good. Tip back out. Ivins once again tries to find Cook, but Ness is there. Rogers going to slow things down. Potentially the last offensive possession. I won't say definitely, because the way that Red Devil defense has looked.
Yeah, they could easily score here and then get another steal.
Seidel with it, 12 on the shot clock, 18 on the game clock. Kutrick in the post, puts it up and in.
We talked about how her and Styler are really interchangeable, having post games and able to stretch it all the way to the three. And you see her, you know, after a few misses from three, just going down and getting the easy one.
No good there from Boya. Ness has it, and that will close out the third quarter. Rogers almost knocks it in after the buzzer. But 41-15, our score at halftime. Josh, taking a look at the stats, man, it's been a really good game for Eureka.
Yeah, it's been a very, very good game. As we've kind of hinted at a few times, a very well-balanced effort from a lot of the team, still holding this Kalamazoo team below 25% from the field. You know, that they've sent them to the free throw line only four times, so they haven't been fouling a lot. And even then, misses from Kalamazoo, they're only shooting 50% at the line. The Red Devils themselves shooting about 77%, so they've converted for the most part. And then that defense just one-upped itself. After holding Kalamazoo to 9 points in the first quarter, they held them to 6 here in the second quarter. And won for a good, I think, 8 minutes. So, you know, this defense is really, really giving them nightmares right now. And it's great to see the Red Devils coming out with such intensity.
A lot of good things to look for in the second half of action. That's all we have for the first half. 41-15 our score. Eureka leading. We're going to be back after halftime. You're watching Eureka College Basketball on ACTV.
This is the story of a boy who didn't talk for a long time. The boy liked things to always be the same. Any changes would scare and upset him. The unknown was an unfriendly place. The boy was very sensitive to lights and sounds. So he built secret hiding places where they couldn't get in. The boy didn't like looking people in the eye. He wasn't trying to be mean, it just made him feel uncomfortable. Sometimes he would flap his arms again and again.
One day I found out I have something called autism. My family got me help. Slowly, I found my voice and learned all the way I could live with it better.
Early intervention can make a lifetime of difference. Learn the signs at autismspeaks.org.
It's not my first time bartending, so.
It's a sausage party in hand.
It's fine. I'm very familiar.
Yeah, because you're a sexy girl, Sam. Last thing,
yeah,
is that the music, when Momo kicks it into high gear, is going to get a little bit loud in here, mm-hmm. So your customers are going to have a hard time hearing you. So you may want to.
What?
Make sure they don't get too close.
If you love them enough to suck the snot out of their nose at 4 a.m., then surely you'll check nhtsa.gov/the right seat to make sure they're in the right car seat.
1 in 3 adults has prediabetes. That means it could be you, your favorite brother, your other brother,
yes.
You, your football buddy, your football buddy. You. Your plumber.
Breathe right into your foot.
Your plumber's masseuse.
Yes.
You. Your dog walker. Your cat jogger. With early diagnosis, prediabetes can be reversed. Take the risk test at doihaveprediabetes.org.
Look at you. You're at the top of your game. You're unstoppable. Nothing can throw you off track. Wait, is that your car? Uh-oh. Yeah, I saw that coming. That will throw you off track. You're looking at around 10 grand in fines, legal fees, and increased insurance rates. Let's try this again. Smart move. Because buzz driving is drunk driving.
Those socks are school colors. Are those your wrestling socks?
Yeah. I thought our full body would be in the media.
Practice down there, it's colder.
No, we like the purple mat.
Yeah, that mat sucks, I'm not gonna lie.
Why? It's the same. It's the same.
Oh, this is my song too. Is it? No.
Creasy's not here yet. Is Creasy sleeping again? Whoa. Yeah, those are. All right, hey, bring it in. Good job. All right, hey, listen up. Today's the day, cook. Oh, yeah. Roll straight to your feet. Straight to the feet. Everybody watch cook. See if you can do it. Still can't do it.
I'm a very noisy wrestler. They're gonna hear all my grunts every time I shoot. I see it. Don't worry.
2022. I'm Devils.
Braden won. Bobby won. Bobby beat you. You weren't even racing anybody. Hunter won. Berta won. Who's gonna win? Creasy won.
By the way, if somebody says that Beal beat me in a bench off, that was not on record. It's never been recorded, and it never happened. So just have to throw that out there.
Biscuit.
Oh, ho, ho.
Clock says July.
Please don't actually throw me.
I'm not. You stabbed me in my
head. With the mic? Did I mention Hunter was big? Because he is.
So why not find someone new? Oh god. Did you guys do the sideways ones? The sideways ones.
Okay, that's a little bit too aggressive.
Get his shoulder down. Wait, there we go. It's good. Nice.
I gotta be honest
what?
With you, Coach.
You lost all this,
didn't
you? I've got all of them.
Pairs are
yeah. They're hot.
Got a bunch of starfishes around here. Starfish. This is a good challenge.
There's like a 90% chance that Drew's gonna break this because he hurts me every practice.
Okay, wait.
That's not true. It is actually not true.
It is a little true. Oh my god. I gotta get filmed going bottom. Yeah.
bad time.
Wow, okay.
Just hit Drew in the face.
I gotta get my first
blood in.
What's this guy doing here? Put your back on the mat. There you go. Feel a difference? Get this down. Oh, a little back popper there.
Ah! Oh, you would have had me. You should have.
Thought you were in down block.
Oh, I was. I've been sprawling your freaking head.
You're right. Oh, what are you sprawling now? Say.
Your girls have been with you through every moment of your life. They were with you when you felt unbreakable, and with you when you had your heart broken. They were with you when you shared your love with the world, and with you when she became your world. They're still with you right now. But how well do you know them?
Home fire drills give your family a plan of action. In a home fire, you may have less than 2 minutes to get out. So when you drill, show everyone two ways out of the house, pick a safe meeting spot, and get there in under 2 minutes. Then practice home fire drills at least twice a year. You can even make them fun. So everyone knows the sound and exactly what to do when they hear a smoke alarm. Go to ready.gov/firedrill and learn how to prepare your family for home fires.
Meet the Scan, a simple procedure whose mission is to detect lung cancer early.
I'm here to save you.
But I feel fine.
That's great, but you may still be at high risk for lung cancer.
Oh man, that's a new fence.
If you smoke, early detection could save your life. Learn more at savebythescan.org.
You help. Visit aarp.org/caregiving for information on how to provide even better care for the person who once took care of you.
When I was in foster care, I never knew when I would have to move, so I always had my suitcase ready to go. Then one day, I was adopted. My new parents opened their hearts and home to me. My parents cook my favorite breakfast for me every morning. My parents take me on trips I never thought I would go on. They gave me a home and an even better reason to use that suitcase. My parents aren't perfect, but they're perfect for me.
For the love of the game, that's what it's all about, they say. But for those of us who are Division III student athletes, it's more than that.
It's more about team and the schools and communities we represent.
And for the many of us blessed with the strength to compete in sport at the college level, we understand that, with what we were given, comes a special obligation.
An obligation to help those who have their own special needs and whose love for the game is no less intense.
That is why NCAA Division III teamed up with Special Olympics. Since August of 2011, we and others from Division III campus communities have volunteered more than 250,000 hours, time away from the classroom and practice field, reaching across the country to coach and mentor Special Olympics athletes.
And to learn that in giving, we receive so much more in return. Help us keep that dream alive.
Be part of it.
Get involved.
You can make a difference.
I don't remember how it started.
Go to that.
Our back and forth. it always came back.
Dad!
You probably don't remember what you told me.
That was perfect.
But I heard every word.
And welcome back to Eureka, Illinois, the home of the Eureka Red Devils, where they lead 41-15 in another non-con home game here. Spencer Davis, Joshua Howard with you. Josh, this past first half was a good one.
Yes, it was a very good first half. The defense stifling in both quarters, you know, limiting this Hornets team to single-digit points in both quarters, 9 in the first, even better at 6 in the second. And then the Red Devils have found their offense after a frustrating prior game against Illinois Wesleyan. They're able to drop 41 points here in this first half. So they've been scoring very well. We've seen a little bit of everything. Threes, post-game, backdoor cuts, them getting to the free throw line. It's a very, very welcome sight to see them finally starting to find some comfort in their offense.
What would you say that the Red Devils need to keep doing, or what would you like to see them do even more of to make sure they come home with a win?
So really, first, starting with what they should continue to do more of, that defensive pressure on the ball. They continue to press. You know, they're still playing like this is a close game, like it's a 1-2 possession game. So continuing to keep up that intensity, making sure this team doesn't, they don't allow them any signs of life, any chance to believe that they can come back. And then that offense, just continue to work around, see what the defense gives you, continue to get those good looks closer to the rim. We've seen them get a lot of easy layups or draw fouls. So continuing that aggression around the rim, getting to the bonus early, and getting those free throws knocked down.
We prepare to get this second half of action started. Eureka looking to pick up their first home win of the season, and right now they're in good shape. See if they can keep up the good vibes in this second half. Rogers now to Hanum. Hanum from three. That one left short. Horn with a nice box out. Ball loose. And a foul called. It's going to go on English.
Yeah, that was, I got to say, I'm impressed right there with Rogers, because it seemed like English made it to the ball first, but as if she literally has magnets in her hands. Like, she just, it was there.
Mine.
It was literally in her hands, but yeah, very impressive, able to get the steal, and usually whoever has the ball in the collision gets the foul in their favor, so right there, the Red Devils able to get that one for them.
Rogers to inbound for the Red Devils. It's Moore now. All the way to the basket, off the glass, no good.
Not able to hit right there, but it's always good to see her aggression towards the rim. We talked about how in her first game, I mean her last game before the injury, 16 points on 55% shooting, so we know she can get it going.
Kaufman all the way to the basket. The follow, no good from, well, mix up there underneath, Arlington. Ball's going to stay with the Hornets. Davis now on the wing over to Arlington. Arlington is a leading scorer, and then Ms. Magnets picks it off.
Easy lays.
And the scoring has been started this second half as Eureka moves to a 28-point lead.
Yeah, three straight quarters, the first one on the board here. And you know, we'll see how long they can hold them scoreless again. I don't want to jinx them, but that defense has done good to start quarters.
Horn now fouled, and the basket's good.
That was definitely my fault.
Happens to the best of us.
Every time.
8:58 to go in the third quarter. As Jalen Horn stands at the free throw line looking to convert a three-point play. And unable to do so. And ball gets knocked out of bounds by the Hornets. Arlington came into this game as the leading scorer for the Hornets on the season. She has not scored yet.
That's that defense. They've completely locked her out. As you talked about, leading scorer here, just above, I believe, 10 a game, and not a single point here through two quarters.
Stotler now to Moore. Moore, a little Euro step off the glass, no good. And ball knocked out of bounds by Ness. Ness tried to convince the official otherwise, but it didn't quite work.
You know, it's always good to try here, and you never know if the official's going to be like, you know what? It's yours.
You raise a good point. That would be something.
Understandable. Have a good day.
And a timeout taken. 6 seconds had already passed on that backcourt violation, so they're going to have to cook something up on the sideline to get it across in 4 seconds.
Yeah, they're going to have to work fast as the Eureka defense picks up where it left off, really providing pressure this time, starting on this end of the court after the basket switch. And, you know, I'm pretty sure that the Hornets came out hoping that this rim that the Eureka was playing on the first half was magical, you know, could help them start to get their offense flowing. But really, they still have been struggling here in this defense, doing its job, coming out and applying that pressure once more.
See what play call has been issued to try to get this across. And I guess it resets. Does that reset?
I don't think it does. I was pretty sure it doesn't, but I guess maybe okay. The refs can call differently.
It has been reset. English now all the way to half court. Davis able to get it across just in the nick of time.
That might have been 4 seconds anyway, though.
Yeah.
Honestly. Yeah, they did a good job right there, but the Red Devil defense doesn't really get that much easier in the half court either.
It's going to be Horn with a little rip through, trying to get to the elbow. English able to get open. Three on the shot clock. Shot up. Almost banked in. Ness with the rebound. Ness now with 11 boards tonight. Stotler, Hannum. Hannum all the way to the basket. Can't finish. Arlington controls that rebound. It's her 10th of the night.
I wouldn't be surprised if Arlington's a little, you know, a little frustrated, as you kind of alluded to. She's been held scoreless, and a lot of that has been Ness really dominating their matchup thus far.
Arlington misses once again. Stotler rebounds. Able to keep it inbounds to Moore.
And on cue, a miss right there by her, and Red Devils able to get out and get an easy bucket here possibly.
Hannum now able to keep it. Hands off Ness. Ness able to escape the scrum. 16 on the shot clock. Plenty of time to run a play. Here's Ness. Hannum, open look from three. That one no good. A lot of open looks so far from the Red Devils, just unable to knock any down yet.
Yeah, it seems like their shooters start to get rolling a little bit in the first half, and then, you know, it's just struggles, though. We expect them to pick it up, and it's just good to see them really getting those good looks on offense, because it shows you their offense generates a lot of quality looks, and they continue to knock those down, or if they start to knock them down, it's going to show how much better a team they can be.
Moore now from three. That one no good. Rebounded by Ness. Ness puts it in off the glass. Oh, close.
We almost had another in one. Opportunity at least.
The Ivins and Brines onto the court, and Cook as well for the Hornets. And that free throw knocked in. First free throw made for Ness tonight. 6:46 left in this third quarter. Lead back up to 28 now for the Red Devils. Ness with 6 points and 12 rebounds so far tonight. Plenty of time to keep pumping those numbers up off the face of Horn.
I couldn't tell if that was face or shoulder. Either way, a great defensive stand there for the Red Devils as they get another turnover.
Rogers now driving off the glass, contacting in.
As easy as ever for her.
13 points on the night for Shekiah Rogers.
Like, yeah, the second leading scorer coming into this game for the Red Devils, already surpassing her average. And now the lead reaching a new height of 30 as they get another turnover.
Backcourt violation on that one. Turnover battle sitting at 2-28 now.
This is the effort you'd like to see coming off of a game where the Red Devil women were likely disappointed in the way they played against Wesleyan. A lot of things that they don't typically do, they did in that game. And coming out and just going up 32 points, not even midway through the third quarter, that's a great effort, and that's a great, great way to respond to a tough loss.
English now still trying to break the press. Horn able to find Brines. That's probably the quickest they've been able to get across half court in the last few minutes.
It's definitely got to be up there.
Horn setting a screen now. Ivins. Cook back to English. Rogers trying to guard the post. Blocks. Ivins miss.
a little bit of Nate Robinson blocking Yao Ming right there. Just Rogers not caring how tall her opponent is, still getting the stuff.
Rogers left open at the three-point line and knocks it in. Shakaya Rogers having a fantastic game tonight.
Yeah, up to 16 now, an efficient 16 at that.
...52-17 our score halfway through the third. Maddie Jernigan preparing to come in. As is Kaylin Arlington. Horn to the basket, no good, rebounded by Rogers. Rogers up to Ness, a little collision between her and Hannum. Ness jump stops and puts it in.
For a second it looked like Hannum was taking her time to get up there, but she looks fine, a smile on her face. They're able to convert another basket off turnovers.
Horn in the post, looking to go back door to English. Good hands by Rogers. On the break, Moore is going to jump, stop, and finish. And a timeout taken by the Hornets. The lead is now at 39. Josh, hot start to the third.
Yeah, great effort once again. The defense stifling once again. Two straight, or three straight, I'm not sure. Possessions on offense, they've been able to get from forcing turnovers, just easy layups out there first. Ness, and this time Moore. Everything's looking great. It's looking like they're running on all cylinders. 15 points here, and they're just over halfway through this quarter. So this team is performing the way we know they can. They came out, like I said, they came out like this is still a close game. Like they're playing a competitive team, and like they've got to pull away.
And you love to see it again. They're still looking for their first home win. I would say right now, almost can lock it in, but it's a really good sign from this team, especially as the conference schedule starts to come up in January.
Yeah, it's a really good sign. They're starting to mesh. They're starting to gel. A lot of them returning anyway, so the chemistry in theory shouldn't be that hard to get back. But it's good to see that by the fifth game of the season, they're starting to look really good and really comfortable playing with one another.
We talked about it early on in the first quarter about whether or not Kalamazoo would crack 40 turnovers. It's probably going to happen. They're at 30 right now, halfway through the third.
Yeah, it looks
fantastic
like we're going to get
defense.
It.
Fantastic defense.
Fantastic, truly. And the fact that every single quarter started off really the same way. Eureka's at 10 points before Kalamazoo's even at like 2 or 4. It's impressive.
4:20 remaining in this third quarter. 56-17 our score. Pass deflected. Cook still with it. Cook now looking to drive. Finds herself kind of by herself. English now deep 2 up and in.
Her second trade of the game, I believe.
I could be wrong, but I thought it was only a 2.
It may be a 2.
It was as close as you can get to it being a 3, though, I will say. Rogers now looking to go to work with Ness. Pick and roll. Kicks out corner 3 from Murphy. No good. Rebounded by Brines. Then trapped in the corner. Really bad spot. Ivins able to kind of just fling it out. Cook with it. Jernigan pokes it loose. And a 10-second call once again.
I got to say right there, it may have been better on that initial, you know, that poke away that where they got trapped in the corner for her to let it roll out. It looked like it kind of touched the knee right there of Rogers, but either way, the Red Devils able to force the turnover. I'm definitely not mad at it.
Hand them now. And Jernigan. 56-19, looking to get that lead up to potentially 40. Hand them in the post, bullies her way to the basket. No more press, it seems. Sad.
They're trying to let him breathe a little bit, at least.
We're classy.
No, we'll go up 40 on you, but then...
then we will pull off the press.
Yeah, yeah. Well, you know, we're not too mean.
Deflected out of bounds by Hannum.
I'm not sure what D1 game it was I saw earlier this week, but I think UConn or something beat someone 100-37, their women's team. So, you know, they're like, we're not going to do you like that. We are going to win, though.
Don't count us out, though.
Yeah, don't count us out.
We might. See what happens. Plenty of game left.
Plenty of game left indeed. 13 minutes here.
Arlington now looking to drive baseline. And ball knocked out of her hands. It's only going to be 4 seconds on the shot clock. Reese Puchert back into the game. Ness heads to the bench. Great game from her so far. 8 points, 12 rebounds, 3 assists.
Great all-around game. Nearly a double-double.
Arlington turns around, puts it up. No good still. Davis puts it up. No good. Rebounded by Rogers. Rogers has been everywhere so far tonight. Kutrick with it now. It's Jernigan. Working in that high post area. Senior guard with Sydney Hannum. 10 on the shot clock. Pick and roll with Jernigan. Pick and pop, excuse me. Jernigan head fake. Puts one up from the free throw line. No good. And then rebounded by Arlington.
And I got to say, Kalamazoo probably taking a sigh of relief for the first time since the game started. With Ness not on the floor, the ball pressure on a lot of the ball handlers is slightly easier, but still the Red Devils able to do enough to get a turnover. So it really doesn't seem to matter who is guarding.
Murphy that time with the steal. Hannum. And picked off by Davis. The Hornets now on the break. And then blocked by Rogers.
Once again, Rogers does not care how tall you are. She's going to get the stop.
Putrick now to the corner. Jernigan left open from three. Not quite. And rebounded by Ivins.
I love the unselfishness, though. Putrick could have arguably taken that to the post. Gotten a bucket. We've seen her do it already this game. But she gets the wide open three look for Jernigan, who is going to knock that down most of the time.
Murphy with that rebound. Third of the night. Rogers now. A little crossover. A little contact. Can't quite put it in. 1 point forward there for the Hornets. Kaufman able to get some separation. Turns around. Puts it up. No good. Ball tipped out. And they're going to say it's off of the Red Devils.
Interesting.
To each their own, I suppose. Minute 3 remaining third quarter action. 58-19 our score. Home Devils all over them.
Yeah, Devils just, they've been making this game hard from tip and I believe leading wire to wire.
I don't think they've fallen behind. I think you're right.
Yeah, the closest it ever was 7-6 early on, and now obviously they've completely stretched the lead out.
I forget that it was 7-6. We only gave up, like, what, 3 points then for the rest of that quarter?
Yeah, three points for the rest of that quarter after two back-to-back threes.
There's Kaufman at the free throw line. First one good from her. Second trip to the line for her tonight. She went 1 of 2 on the first trip. And that one good as well. Be Murphy now with a minute left. Putrick corner. Seidel is back on the court. Stotler elbow. Good hands. Stotler still has it. Goes out to Rogers. 15 on the shot clock. Bit of shake and bake here. Seidel. Seidel getting a screen from Stotler. Poked out from her. 7 seconds now. Putrick from three. This three-pointer. Whoa. Still looking for that first made three from her. Every one of them looked closer than the other.
Yeah, definitely not expecting these misses to keep going. She's a very good shooter. And she's going to knock down a lot of these open looks in coming games if she continues to get them.
Rebounded by Rogers. 10 seconds left in the quarter. Rogers now looking to put up the last shot. And picked off. So 58-21 the score in favor of the Red Devils as we approach the final quarter. And Eureka on the precipice of their first home win. We've got a break in action. We're going to take that break as well. You're watching Eureka College Basketball on ECTV.
1 in 3 adults has pre-diabetes. That means it could be you, your favorite brother, your other brother, you, your football buddy, your football buddy, you, your plumber.
Breathe right into your foot.
Your plumber's masseuse.
Yes.
You, your dog walker, your cat jogger. With early diagnosis, prediabetes can be reversed. Take the risk test at doihaveprediabetes.org.
Look at you. You're at the top of your game. You're unstoppable. Nothing can throw you off track. Wait, is that your car? Uh-oh. Yeah, I saw that coming.
That will throw you off track. You're looking at around 10 grand in fines, legal fees, and increased insurance rates. Let's try this again.
Smart move.
Because buzz driving is drunk driving.
Welcome back to Bonatti Bullwinkle Arena, where the Red Devils lead 58-21. As we get this fourth quarter started, that'd be quite a score to start.
You know, if anyone's capable, though, I can definitely see us dropping 58 points first quarter. Something light.
The English getting a screen from Arlington.
Good to see the hounding defense not going anywhere. The Red Devils still not letting up on the pressure. Obviously, an entire quarter to go, and they're going to make sure they, as we said in the pregame, play a full 40.
Last two quarters, they've only given up 6 points. Shakiah Rogers to Murphy. And a nice little give and go on that.
Really great to see them start the quarter the way they've started really every quarter. Defensive stop, defensive pressure, and able to get an easy bucket on the other end.
Lead was at 40 at one point earlier. Is that a measly what? 39,
you know.
Seidel Hamburg, that's good. Great finish from Avery Seidel.
Very, very tough bucket there. Still able to power through the bigger defender.
9:06 remaining. I am not sure how she got that to go in. That was a really tough angle.
Hey, she's strong, you know. What foul, you know? She didn't even feel that. Able to just finish through the contact.
And that
we got
good.
Yeah, we got all three this time.
That was the 20th free throw attempt of the night for the Red Devils. 16 of 20, so 80% as a team.
Yeah, we talked about in the previous game how we want to just see them around that healthy 20 mark. It's always good to get a good 5-6 free throws a quarter. That means you're being aggressive. And another steal there. Murphy able to convert the layup.
That one good. 65-21 the score. Murphy with almost another steal. Cook getting a screen. And that pass almost kept in bounds. Going to roll out of bounds. Three players in double figures now for the Red Devils. 14 from Shakiah Rogers, 10 from Marissa Murphy, and 10 from Sydney Hannum. Murphy bringing the ball up the court. English giving her left. Seidel. Putrick. Stotler with it. 15 on the shot clock. Murphy in the corner, guarded by English. Seidel all the way to the basket. Tries to find Stotler. Picked off Brines.
I do like the idea, though. Driving, getting the attention of two defenders, and then dishing off to the big of the paint.
Cook goes over Putrick. And no one was looking for that pass.
One of very, 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 very few inbound mistakes here by the Red Devils. But, you know, just looking to see them play and continue to keep up the way they have been playing. Everyone's going to make a mistake. And they get the ball back anyway, so it didn't really matter.
7:45 remaining for fourth quarter action. Wow, I'm really having problems. Seidel kicking out Putrick. Davis guarding her. Rogers now to Stotler. Hands back off. Rogers kicks out Putrick from three. That three no good. Rebounded by Kaufman. Axis almost an outlet pass. Murphy there to stop the break. And then knocked away. And then knocked away once again. Brian's backdoor cut. Nice find. Can't finish.
The Red Devils defense is so good that just the idea of one of them possibly being near you is going to make you miss.
It's kind of like Trey Young with Ben Simmons.
It's definitely like that. It's definitely like that.
We have Hall of Fame Intimidator badges across the board.
All the way around.
Kaufman now kicking out Davis. Ariel Kism preparing to come back in. Cook trying to work on Stotler. That one no good.
One of the few times seems like the Red Devils going to slow it down, taking their time up the court here.
Stotler with 18 on the shot clock. Little head fake, trying to get by Cook through some contact. Putrick there to clean up.
The real question is, will we get 80? It's not really all that important.
It's not ridiculous to say that.
Yeah, definitely not.
6:13 remaining, 69-23 the score. Kaufman working off of the screen to the basket. Can't convert, but she will get two free throws. Group substitution now. Kism's on for the Red Devils, as is Ness. We want a Ness layup. Double-double then.
Yeah, that's true. I was saying I did want to see. She had to be close to a double-double and 8 points here, so just one bucket. She's able to get it.
Kaufman's first is good. And that one good as well. Be Ivins coming back onto the court for the Hornets. Kism to Ness. Trying to work it back down low. Kism with it. It seems like kind of one of those three out, two in type offenses. You don't see it a lot anymore, but Eureka definitely comfortable with it.
Yeah, you know, a lot of bigs that they're able to play, so there's a lot of size down there and a lot of people to get the ball into the post to have them operate either going for the bucket or possibly playmaking for the rest of the team.
And Ness fouled, so two free throws potentially. As it stands, Eureka will move to 2-3 on the season, picking up their first home win. First free throw spins out.
Still rooting for that double-double, though, so.
We believe. And that one good. Give her 9 on the night, 12 rebounds for Josie Hess. Wow. Josie Ness, apologies. I think I got caught having a good night at the same time.
It happens.
You know. And Putrick trying to draw a charge. Arlington finally gets in the scoring column. 14 rebounds for her and her first points tonight.
Well, it's too late. You know, Ness already won the matchup. Clearly is better. We don't care.
Plus ratio. Ness turning around. Kicks out. Seidel thought about a three. Works it to Putrick. Putrick will try a three. That one left short. Seidel fighting for it. Goes out of bounds. Hornets basketball. To 27 is our score. 5:04 to go in this fourth quarter. Horn driving the lane, blocked by Ness. And then kept alive by Seidel. On the break now, the Red Devils. Seidel all the way, coast to coast, can't finish. Offensive rebound, Ness. Ness off the glass, no good. Gets another chance, and they're going to say she stepped on the line.
That Ness double-double is so close.
Basketball gods, why?
We need it, please. Still, though, it's good to see them hustling, even then, trying to save that ball out of bounds. I continue to say, you know, they're playing like the game score isn't what it is. They're just continuing to give effort.
Arlington now, a couple baskets in a row for her. Once again, a really balanced scoring attack from the Red Devils tonight. 14, 12, 10, 9, 9, 7, 4, 3, 2 from the team. No one they could really focus on. Putrick now from three. Yes!
We knew it was coming. The lid was going to come off the basket eventually. Too good of a shooter for it not to. We finally get a tray ball.
73-29 the score. For as many points as Eureka has scored, they've only had 4 three-pointers.
Yeah, it's impressive. It shows they're able to really get what they want in the lane, getting high percentage shots. or getting free throws.
Arlington no good, rebounded by Seidel. Murphy now on that right side into Ness. Ness going to work with 3:33 remaining. Ness puts it up, no good. Rebounded by Arlington for 15th of the night.
The rim just doesn't want to do its job and give us kind bounces, does it?
She's using the backboard too, so I don't know what to say. That's always what I was taught. Knocked down there by Macy Ivins. Puts her in double figures, 11 points for her tonight. 3 3-pointers to go along with 6 rebounds. Kism now. Thought about shooting. It's going to be Murphy in the corner instead. 15 to go on the shot clock. Runner good, or excuse me, no good.
I believe Kalamazoo possibly having a chance to score the most points they've put up in any single quarter so far in this game.
They already have broken it.
Oh, they already have.
Yep. Quarter's been pretty even, 15 to 11. Unfortunately for Kalamazoo, the rest of the quarters were not so close.
Yeah, and even then, you know, Eureka's average given up here is still going to be, in all likelihood, less than 10 points a quarter. So that shows you how good the defense has been, even though obviously letting up a little bit with the game out of reach here in the fourth.
Boyaz first is no good. Abby Stotler preparing to come in. That one also no good, rebounded by Kism. Putrick now, right side, tries to get it to Kism. It's going to be knocked out of bounds off of Kalamazoo. Good start to the post-Thanksgiving break, I would say.
Yeah, we talked about earlier how we all probably got our stuff. Seems like they did a good job working off the food or whatever. Who knows? Or maybe
powered
it just didn't
up.
Matter.
Powered him up, maybe.
Powered him up. May have re-energized.
Three-pointer from Seidel, good.
I know that definitely didn't work for me. I used to just come in and, like, I would be fat. And then the coach would run me for, like, 3 hours, the entire team, really. But, yeah, it didn't seem to really affect the Red Devil women here and coming out with a great performance.
2:15 remaining in this one. High arcing three-pointer, no good. And Ness has it. Point Ness.
I like that.
Got to start calling her the Loch Ness Monster, honestly. The way that she's played today.
Definitely has been a monster.
On both ends of the floor, that one, no good. Trying to keep it alive, then commits a foul.
This rim just, you know, doesn't want to see Ness succeed. Doesn't want to see the double-double.
Been praying on her downfall, I guess. It's
crazy.
Really unfortunate.
Extremely.
Still got time. 1:45 to go. 76-32 the score. Eureka leading all the way to the basket. Brines. As she gets into the scores column. Ness now. Why not shoot it?
Yeah, what? You know,
me personally.
Not? I would just pull from 80 feet.
She will pop a three. That one was really close. Ness offensive rebound puts it up. Double-double.
She got it.
11 points, 15 rebounds for Josie Ness. 3 assists as well.
Absolutely monstrous effort. The fact that she has more rebounds than points, too, that's impressive. All the while having to battle with Arlington in the paint as well.
Well, pick and roll there. No good from Wedge. Under a minute to go, Seidel. Thought she was going to shoot that three. Here's Putrick over to Kism. Backdoor cut from Seidel. Contact.
And one again. At this point, I'm convinced fouls just don't affect her. She continues to get fouled by larger defenders, and it doesn't matter. She's just going to finish the ball anyway.
Seidel only deals in threes. Three-pointers and three-point plays. Can't convert it, but it's the opportunity.
At this point, I almost feel like making like one of those signs with her name Avery, except the E is a three.
Ooh, good call. We're coming up with so many good marketing
Honestly,
things right now.
We gotta get the ball rolling on this
we do.
Eureka Women's Basketball merch.
NIL merch for sure.
Yeah.
80-34 score. 35 seconds remaining. This is Boyette driving the lane. Little hook shot there. She's from Michigan, so potentially watch enough Xavier Simpson highlights. I would get it. Ness now with it. Power dribble. Puts it up. No good. And pulled away by Seidel. They're just going to dribble it out.
They did get 80.
They did get 80. And Eureka's going to keep the home win.
Yeah.
I don't know how to take home a win. It's like we're here already.
It was a good performance all the way throughout. The offense looked lovely. The defense looked great, looked extremely pressuring, making Kalamazoo uncomfortable from the tip all the way to the very end. And what did we end up with 40 turnovers or what, kind of close?
36 turnovers for Kalamazoo, 5 for Eureka.
Yeah, still 9 a quarter. So that shows that the pressure remained throughout the game and Kalamazoo was never really able to adjust.
A great performance as a team from Eureka. 4 players finish in double figures, but Shakaya Rogers leads the way with 14 points and 4 rebounds. And then Josie Hess, monster stat line, 11 points, 17 rebounds, and 3 assists. And then Macy Ivins contributes 11 and 6 for the visiting Hornets. Joshua, anything else that we want to say about this?
Just that we hope to continue to see this type of effort, this type of intensity from them moving forward. We know they're capable of it on a nightly basis. And, you know, a few close losses that they've had this season is a misrepresentation of their record. So they continue to build in this right direction. We know that they're going to turn it around, probably string together some wins here soon.
And that's all that we have for you. Our next broadcast of Eureka College basketball is coming up very soon. Give me a second.
I believe this Wednesday, a women's game.
Okay. Looking forward to that. Yes, November 30th, Wednesday, against the University of Chicago. Tip-off time set for 7 o'clock. It's going to be right here on ECTV. Just want to thank everyone for contributing. For cast and crew, I'm Spencer Davis, and for Joshua Howard, thank you for tuning in. We'll be right back.